It's the 2015 FSLOW Awards. Starring Scooter Mattoon, Nick Nolte, the Kool-Aid guy, Ray Liotta, a sexy Adolf Hitler, Wee Jesus, with special performances by Figment the Dragon, Fat Christina Aguilera, and the Elephant Man. And now, your host for tonight's festivities, Commissioner Tanzer. Welcome to the 2015/16 FSLOW Awards. Commissioner here, you're there. This is a microphone, I'm talking into it. You've waited long enough. You know, I've been a little bit busy making America great again, but I finally came around and got this fucking award show together. So thankful that you guys are there watching. I try to make this as brief as possible. I don't want to banter too much, so let's just jump right in. Let's just head first, boom, first award. Let's get to it. Best slash most entertaining slash whatever couple of the year came down to like one vote. Tight race. But let's get right to it. The nominees are the Mangans, the Stacks, the Godzers, the Joneses. Taking home the double-sided dog toy dildo will be... Oh, they deserve each other for all the wrong reasons. Dan Stack and Gary Smith, congratulations, fellas. You're the best slash worst slash and most entertaining couple. I guess deservedly so, but I hope that some other couple emerges next year to dethrone you. I have a feeling that they will. Could possibly be in this household. All right, on to the next award. It's going to be Capper's biggest abortion of a prediction of the year that he made at the draft. They're four pretty poor ones. The nominees are... Nominee number one, the Dolphins will win the AFC East decisively. The Patriots finishing last. Nominee number two, Holly. Her wheels will come off with the selection of Cam Newton, who ended up being the second overall highest scorer. Nominee number three, Capper would finish 8-5, really 4-9, and make it to the finals against EJ. He was in last place. The playoffs were said and done. Nominee number four, Goss would miss the playoffs, and Brady would play zero factor in his season. I found this little figurine at a thrift store. It's an Australian Wanderer. Kind of looks like Capra a little bit, so he'll be getting this as part of his award. But the winner is, see, once again, very exciting. Nominee number two, Holly's wheels will come off with the selection of Cam Newton, probably the league MVP. And the second highest scorer overall. Capper, I will say you this, that no matter how wrong or right you are, the pure entertainment value of your post-draft analysis is worth every penny. So we appreciate you doing it, and I hope that you're doing it for the foreseeable future. It is one of the highlights of the year. All right, so in a ceremony a little bit earlier today, some technical awards were given out for achievement and Facebook stuff. And being an asshole, among other things. So let's see that little cool montage of the technical awards earlier today. Hit it! Best villain, runaway winner, Dan Stack, I think we all can agree. A relentless asshole and prick throughout the entire season. Always good for offending someone, but yet not taking it so well. Looking forward to 2016. For a meme achievement, Tyler Robinson, using the Will Ferrell Olin Mills double face shot. This was to Dan Stack in response to his Todd Gurley Calvin Johnson trade to me. Nice job, Tyler. Great zinger. We all enjoyed that. Of course, he didn't take it well, but well done, sir. I'm going to jump in real fast. This one is for Facebook Page Person of the Year. A distinct achievement because there's so much competition. This is very hard to come to a winner on this one. And the reason being is because we have all 12 of us are on there and doing your job to make this league, very difficult to run and very difficult to be a part of, but in a good way. So this is a very prestigious award, and it goes to the one and only Gary Smith. He did a wonderful job, constantly active, funny, engaging, offensive, all the things that we love. And here's a couple of Gary memories. All right, something possessed us this year to start using a lot of photos of dead animals, and I'm not sure why. We probably blame Dan or Gary, as usual. But some good ones this year. Very offensive. Hit close to home. Angered some people. I love it. So let's look at the nominees for best, maybe worst, use of a dead animal photo. Goss for the dolphin that got cut. Stack, fly fox. Stack again, raccoon, get well soon. And Gary for the husky in a trash bag that was likely dead. And he was even offended himself so much he took it down, and we can't find it anywhere. I think it's pretty obvious winning the now empty Christmas cookie tin will be Gary Smith. Wow, cleaning up. Fortunately, he could not close in the playoffs, but you know what? I guess the awards, that's sort of a thing. So good for you for the dead husky in the trash bag. You vile, awful man. But once again, I'm proud of you. All right, we got two more awards to go. The next one is going to be person who has not won the league yet and most likely to win in 2016. The nominees are Holly, Jody Vining, T-Rob. Hey, that's me. Capper. Gary Smith, and winning a used copy of Ace of Base, The Sign. Let's see who won this one. For a person who hasn't won the league yet, but most likely to become the champion in 2016. Seems a little biased, seems like I fixed it, but I promise the winner is me. Sorry, motherfuckers, I win. Because all that she wants is another baby. Proud of that one. Thank you, everybody, for voting. I feel like that's just to kiss my ass or because you feel bad for me for some reason. I don't know. Whatever. All right, that leads us to our last category. My personal favorite, wrap-up of the year. I hope you all enjoyed them. I enjoy making them, and I enjoy you being part of it. I don't even know what the fuck I'm going to do for next year. I always run out of ideas somewhere around week 13. So anyway, so let's get to wrap-up of the year. The nominees are... Week 10, the Charlie Sheen interview.
You know what? You did a pretty bad rap, and I'm not really sure why. And I kind of want some tacos. Let's have a beer.
Poof, you're a gadfly.
Gadfly it is, but we're not sharing needles.
You're a freaking hairy chicken with a corndog limp.
Sure. Love it. See you guys next week.
Week 7, creepy Russian guy yodeling after my overdose, then getting CPR.
For about 13 seconds, man. You ready to go?
Yeah, I'm getting hungry. What do you want to eat?
Chick-fil-A.
What time is it close?
Oh, shit. 5 minutes.
Week 3, Girls, 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 featuring special performances by Officer Aaron Goss, Aaron Jones, and Holly Godby.
Because it looks like your wheels are about to come off. Do you have your license, registration, proof of insurance, please?
I don't understand. I thought our wheels were totally fine. We check them all the time.
I'll be back in a minute. Here's your information back. I'm not going to give you any citations today, but I'm going to give you a little bit of advice. Don't get too cocky about how you did it during 1 week. When you're undefeated 3-0, then you can come talk to me. Have a nice day.
Week 5, condescending Husky rap. Not proud of this one. Finally, week number 4, Mr. Commish's neighborhood.
Lovely day to be 3-1. Unless you're 1-3. It's a lovely day to talk some shit. A lovely day to talk some shit, so go fuck yourself. I've always wanted to win this league, just like you. Always want to slide that jacket on like you, so let's make the most of this beautiful day. And since we're together, we might as well say, could you be mine? Won't you be mine? Won't you stop talking shit? Won't you please? Won't you please? Please won't you stop talking shit.
All right, the moment you've all been waiting for. I've been waiting for it. Wrap up of the year. A culmination of a lot of hard work. I want to thank all those who participated, and Holly especially for shooting a lot of that stuff and putting up with me every Tuesday and Wednesday, usually making all that dumb shit work. But this was a landslide, I hate to say it. All but one person voted for the Week 7 overdose dream sequence with the Russian guy getting CPR thing. That was awesome. Thank you so much to Keenan and Kyle for helping out on that one. That was a lot of fun to make. All right, that's it. The award show, it's over. It's done. I want to thank everybody for your participation and for your patience and everything. Tom especially for being the consigliere. You is a permanent position. You have it as long as you want it. Thank you. You took a lot of heat off of me, and it made my year that much more enjoyable. And that's pretty much it. So Matt Jones, Aaron Jones, Stack, Gary, Jody, Tyler, Holly, Aaron Goss, Gary, I think I got everybody, Pavano, the Mangans. Everybody, you got a capper. You guys are amazing. Thank you so much for everything. And if I'm not mistaken, you can start mock drafting now. You got like 8 months. No excuses. You know, look, Aaron did the work. Here he is. $1,000 richer. So thank you all again. We'll see you next year. Viva la FSLOW.